Penguin Random House Audio presents Blackmail and Bibingka by Mia P. Manansala. Read for you by Danice Cabanela. To James, your love and support have meant everything to me. For that, I'll let you be the funny one in this relationship. For now. Let's grab some steamed hams later. Love you 3000 kissy face emoji. Author's note. Thank you so much for picking up Blackmail and Bibingka. Lila and I are in much better places than we were in book two. But this is still a crime fiction series, and I touch on some topics that can be rather troubling. As usual, I'd like to give my listeners a heads up for potentially triggering content, which I'll list now. If you'd like to avoid possible spoilers, feel free to skip ahead. Content warning. Substance abuse, gambling addiction, infidelity, emotional abuse, police corruption, family abandonment, physical violence, mentions of suicide. Glossary and pronunciation guide. Honorifics, family. The O usually has a short, soft sound. Anak, offspring, son, daughter. Ate, older sister, female cousin, girl of the same generation as you. Guya, older brother, male cousin, boy of the same generation as you. Lola, lolo, grandmother, grandfather. Ninang, ninong, godmother, godfather. Tita, tito, aunt, uncle. Food, adobo, considered the Philippines' national dish. It's any food cooked with soy sauce, vinegar, garlic, and black peppercorns, though there are many regional and personal variations. Bibingka, lightly sweetened rice cake, commonly consumed around Christmas. There are many varieties, but the most common is baked or grilled in a banana leaf-lined mold and topped with sliced salted duck eggs, butter, sugar, and or coconut. Buko, young coconut. Champorado, sweet chocolate rice porridge. Lambanog, Filipino coconut liquor. Lumpia, Filipino spring rolls, many variations. Matamis na bao, coconut jam, also known as minatamis na bao. Pandan, tropical plant whose fragrant leaves are commonly used as a flavoring in Southeast Asia, often described as a grassy vanilla flavor with a hint of coconut. Bandesal, lightly sweetened Filipino rolls topped with breadcrumbs. Patis, fish sauce. Binipig, young glutinous rice that's been pounded flat, then toasted. Looks similar to Rice Krispies. Salabat, Filipino ginger tea. Tuyo, dried salted fish, usually herring. Ube, purple yam. Other, Brew-ha, witch, from the Spanish Brew-ha. Macapagal, a Filipino surname. Mayabang. This term has several meanings depending on context, but here it's being used to mean show-off. Noche Buena, Christmas Eve. From Spanish, it literally translates to good night. Oh my gulay. This is Taglish, Tagalog English slang, used when people don't want to say the God part of OMG. Gulay literally means vegetable, so this phrase shouldn't be translated. Parol, star lanterns commonly used as Christmas decorations in the Philippines. Simbang Gabi, 9-day series of Catholic masses before Christmas, literally translates to nine nights. Chismis. Gossip. Chapter 1. Adina, can you please shut that off? If I have to listen to that Mariah Carey song one more time! I scratched out the third mistake I'd made while trying to finalize the menu for the annual Shady Palms Winter Bash. It tied with the Founders Day celebration as the biggest event in my tiny town of Shady Palms, Illinois. Population, 18,751. And this was the first year my business, my dream, the Brew-ha Cafe, would be participating. Considering what a mess the Founders Day celebration had turned out to be, I really needed to wow at this party. Despite obsessing over it for the past month, I had less than 2 weeks till the big bash and hadn't finalized anything. My best friend and business partner, Adina Awan, turned the cafe's speaker system down to a decibel that didn't make my ears bleed. Way to be a humbug, Lila. Miss Mariah cannot and will not be silenced. Her lambs will make sure of it. Hun, you don't even celebrate Christmas. Why do you have all of these? Elena Torres, Adina's girlfriend and the third and final member of the Brew-ha Cafe crew, aka our voice of reason, scrolled through the cafe's playlist on Adina's laptop. It currently had no fewer than 10 Christmas music compilations that she'd had on repeat since December 1st. It was only December 4th, and I was ready to ban her from programming the shop's playlists ever again. Elena raised her eyebrows at the mix of both religious and secular Christmas songs. Were you secretly raised in an intensely Catholic family like Lila and me? Because this is a lot. Adina laughed and handed Elena her morning cup of yerba buena tea. No, I just like the music. It started as me being rebellious as a kid. Well, as rebellious as you could be in my house. You didn't grow up here, but Shady Palms has a pretty big Muslim and Jewish population. So it was easy to keep Christmas out of schools. But there were still all the commercials and Christmas specials on TV, so I got kind of obsessed with the holiday. I'm mostly over it now, but I still love the music and movies. And also the parties, because Lila's family goes all in on the holiday. Despite my humbug response, as Adina put it, I really did love the holidays. The food, the parties, the gifts, the karaoke, the fantastically cheesy and comfortingly predictable holiday romance movies. What wasn't to love? I mean, I wasn't like the rest of my family, who used to put up Christmas decorations in September. Something about the Christmas season starting in the burr months. Till I convinced them to at least wait until the day after Thanksgiving. But I already had a Google spreadsheet prepared for all the holiday movies the Brew-has and I were going to watch, and had no fewer than 10 cookie recipes I wanted to test. There's a reason it was taking me so long to finalize things for the winter bash. However, I was finding it hard to get into the holiday spirit ever since my long-lost cousin Ronnie came back into our lives a few days ago. 15 years of nothing, only for the prodigal son to show up on our doorstep like nothing had happened, saying he'd bought a winery just outside of town and would be staying in Shady Palms for the foreseeable future. Overjoyed would be an understatement regarding Tita Rosie's reaction to seeing her only child for the first time in over a decade. If she wasn't filling his plate with third and fourth helpings, she was touching his face and fighting off tears as if she couldn't believe he was real. I couldn't believe it either. Considering everything he put her through, the kindest thing he did for our family was leave, just like his father had before him.
Let them go,
Lola Flor had muttered when I was a kid, as we watched first Tito Jeff and then, a few years later, Ronnie abandon us. Tita Rosie sobbing alone in her room each time.
The Macapagal women will do just fine without them.
My grandmother had been right. Maybe it had taken a while, but the Macapagal women thrived without them. Tita Rosie's kitchen, our family restaurant, sat right next door to the Brew-ha Cafe and was now doing so well that people from all over the Midwest came down to Shady Palms just to enjoy my family's food. That's right. Our hole-in-the-wall restaurant was now a tourist destination. Thanks to that, we finally had enough money to hire outside help and, get this, my aunt and grandmother could actually take a whole...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.